mistakes, shame, and guilt. That understanding alone is enough to deliver a troubled heart from guilt and condemnation. The Bible uses the Red Sea scenario to describe what happens in the life of a believer. It was at the Red Sea that those who were redeemed from the death by the blood of the Lamb in Egypt were separated from their past and the enemy by their deliverance through the Red Sea. It was those waters that sanctified them, from their past enslavement. Can you imagine how powerful baptism becomes in the life? Can you imagine how powerful the baptism becomes in the life of a new believer who realized that their old life, habit, addiction, or whatever chased or haunted them will be drowned in the rites of the baptism? That even as Pharaoh was unable to follow them through the Red Sea, those past sins, terrors that would continue to attach themselves to you, have been redeemed by the blood. That even as Pharaoh was unable to follow them through the Red Sea, those past sins and tears that would continue to attach themselves to you after you had been redeemed by the blood would have to give you up to God as you pass through the water. 1 Corinthians 10:1-2, Moreover, brethren, I would not that you should be ignorant how that all our fathers were under the cloud, all passed through the sea, and were all baptized. 908 souls, or 908. What is that? Okay, baptism. That's not making sense right there. Finally, the word baptism is taken from the Greek word baptisma, B-A-P-T-I-S-M-A. It literally means to immerse. It is deeper than a sprinkle. No one would sprinkle dirt on a dead man. They would completely bury him so that his dead carcass would no longer be seen among us. We bury so that the old man, decays his odor, would not be present among us. It is with that same spirit that we bury believers through the baptism. So that the old man decays, we want no visible trace of him. We want no stench remaining upon us from our past. What an embarrassment it would be for our old past life to be able to permeate the new life that we have now. We are buried with him by baptism into death that the body of sin might be destroyed. If it is dead, my friend, get rid of it. Romans 6:6-8 says, knowing this, that our own man is crucified with him, and that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin. For he that is dead is freed from sin. Now if we be dead with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. As you prepare your heart to death, Be baptized. As you prepare your heart to be baptized, please know that this is not just a ceremony for the spiritual
aristocratic.
Okay. This is a declaration of independence. It is a public statement to the powers that held you in your past. It literally means that the old man that you used to know is dead. That you will see them no more. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray that you will begin to realize that his work has freed you from the penalty, the habit, eventually the presence of sin. I challenge all believers, but particularly those who have a darkened past and broken lives, to use the rites of baptism to celebrate the fact that your past is just that. It is your past. You need now, as never before, to reckon your past to be dead. The word reckon means to account it as it were dead. I would like to pray for you that when you come out of the water, your mind would totally be set on things that are above and not on things below. And he has a prayer. Lord Jesus, as I prepare to be baptized, I thank you for the dying to give new meaning to the ceremony.
What page are you on?
19.
Is that about the end of it?
Yep.
Let me have it. I'm going to stop there. If you need to know any more, because it's taking longer than I intended. Now, she gave a... in the beginning...